Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan. On a previous video of mine, I think I made it about a week ago and uploaded about a week ago, I talked about the future of Nintendo Wii U. And I kind of said this. I said that I think it's a really good thing that Nintendo is doing its own thing in E3 and not doing the big gigantic press conference that they've always done in the past. And because from ever since they released the U, from that point on, Nintendo's press conferences have always sucked. You know, they have never been good. So I was just like, yeah, it might actually be a good thing that Nintendo is not doing a press conference, but instead doing it this way, of engaging with their consumers and their fans directly through their own streaming network and doing Nintendo Direct, so it speaks directly to their consumers and updating gamers regularly about their upcoming games and their plans for the future of Nintendo products. Seems like a good idea. That's what I said originally, but E3 is pretty much almost over now, and this video, this is me kind of going, yeah, I retract that statement. I disagree with my past self. Nintendo made a big mistake here by not participating in E3. Their press conferences probably might have sucked. I mean, if this was all they had, even if this was all they had, actually, the games that they announced through their Nintendo Direct, if this is all they had, I think it still would have made a bigger impact than doing this Nintendo Direct way. Because it really doesn't sell anyone on the future of Nintendo, their vision for the future of Nintendo. I didn't get any sense of that, and now Wii U is just kind of like this thing that people should buy to play Nintendo games, and that's pretty much it. And the kinds of Nintendo games that people are going to be playing on their Wii U in the future are the games they played before, just with higher graphics. Nintendo really played it safe this E3. I think they're, in some ways, one could argue that they had the best showing in E3 as a publisher. Some people would make that argument, and I wouldn't disagree. But some people could argue that they had the worst showing in E3 in 2013, and I wouldn't disagree either. Here's the thing. The games that they showcased, they're actually pretty damn awesome games, right? Super Smash Bros. For the Wii U and for the 3DS, first time this franchise is going portable. It looks awesome. I mean, Super Smash Bros. Is what it is. People are always excited for that game, and the producer behind that game is a perfectionist. And he likes really putting all these little details and unique things about that game that makes it so super fun. Super Smash Bros. Is a fun franchise. Super Mario 3D World, which pretty much takes the concept of Super Mario 3D Land and puts it on the Wii U, looks awesome. It looks like such a fun game. Mario Kart Wii U, I think, is the most innovative game of the whole bunch. It does all these crazy things with, you know, verticality and courses twisting itself. It looks awesome. That game looks awesome. Rare's new game, Donkey Kong Tropic Freeze, looks awesome. I mean, new Super Luigi U, and all these games look awesome. X, the spiritual sequel to Xenoblade Chronicles. My God, I think that's the game I'm actually most excited for. Not counting Metal Gear Solid 5, because Metal Gear Solid 5 I'm just a fanboy for, but that's like, to me, if I discounted Metal Gear Solid 5, X would probably be my game of show for E3, right? So, on this lineup alone, and this is not even including the 3DS lineup, Nintendo has an amazing lineup of games that are going to be so freaking awesome, right? So, why aren't people excited? Here's the thing. Because these games are not, like, as awesome as they're gonna be, it's still true to say that, like, I'm really disappointed that Rare is gonna do another Donkey Kong. Just the 2D side platforming Donkey Kong. It's because we know that Rare could be doing something much more innovative. Something much more, like, crazy shockingly awesome. I mean, it's gonna be awesome, but it's like, Mario 3D World is gonna be awesome, right? It's gonna be an awesome game, but it's like the same concept that you had for the 3DS game, and then just putting it over there. And the concept for the 3DS game, the Super Mario 3D Land, is actually just like you know, it's a, that's a very fun game. I enjoyed playing it on my 3DS. But it's a game that really just strikes you with nostalgia. Like, hey, remember all those fun you had with the previous 2D Mario games and the previous 3D games? Well, this is like jam-packed into one. So it's like games you pretty much played before. And it's now going to be a Wii U. Mario Kart 8. I think that's pretty much the most innovative of the bunch. Super Smash Brothers. Like, okay. These are like safe bets for Nintendo. It's exactly what we expect out of them. It doesn't surprise us. It doesn't wow us. And I think that's the problem with this lineup. It's just like, you know what? These games are awesome. These are traditional, awesome, fun Nintendo games. But like, this is the future of Wii U. It's just pretty much, you know, the regular Mario or Donkey Kong or these franchises just coming to Wii U. It seems to be that's the strategy, and it's not surprising, and it's not exciting. And just putting them out there as this Nintendo Direct and being like, hey, here are the games that are going to happen on the Wii U in 2014. It's not even in the near future. I mean, Super 3D World is this holiday season, in December, I believe. Zelda Wind Waker HD in August. Wonderful 101 is going to happen on September. So each month, they're going to have something. Oh, and Pikmin 3 is going to happen on October, I think. So each month, they're going to have something. And all of these games look fantastic. I would love to be able to play Wonderful 101. Pikmin 3 looks very innovative with how it uses the gamepad. But there is this lingering feeling of, like, Nintendo, like, I wanted more. I mean, does that make us gamers too whiny and too entitled? Maybe. But I think the problem is the communication error here. I think the problem is not with the games, because the games look awesome. But I think this was the chance for Nintendo to actually have a press conference and to be like, this is what we're planning our future of Wii U to be. We know it's like this, and this is what we're planning for the Wii U. And even announce like a price cut or something. That would have been fantastic. But it's just like, here are the games, check it out, and yeah, that's it. Just showing the games at E3 doesn't really mean much anymore. You actually gotta sell us on the company, on the future of the Wii U. I think they did with 3DS, I think they can sell the future of 3DS with just showing the games, because we have a good solid footing of 3DS's position in the gaming landscape. There's tons of games for 3DS. We already know that 3DS has great third-party support. And there's even more games, awesome games, coming out for 3DS. You know, Pokemon, Super Smash Bros. Is also for 3DS. Sonic Lost World is also for 3DS. It's also for Wii U. But with the Wii U, it's just like third-party doesn't even exist. I don't think it seems like Nintendo doesn't care. That's the weird thing. Nintendo doesn't seem to care that third-party developers are not willing to, not really getting down there and being eager to develop games for it, develop exclusive games for it. Because so far, the third-party support for the Wii U is as follows. Batman, Arkham Origins, Deus Ex, Human Revolution, Director's Cut, Rayman, Legends. That's it! Or actually, Assassin's Creed 4, sorry. But that's like it. Is Call of Duty Ghosts going to come on the Wii U? I don't know. That's really important for Wii U, actually. But, I mean, it's the same thing with Wii. Wii didn't have any Call of Duty games until it was ported way later. Wii has Call of Duty 4 Modern Reflex Edition. I don't know what that was about. Anyway, I think the only time the Wii actually had something that was a simultaneous release was Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. That didn't do so well in the Wii, which makes sense. Because the online network, I just bought myself a Wii recently, and man, the connecting to internet on this thing is what the heck, so primitive. It makes PlayStation Network look like, I don't know, look like the future of in 2020. But yeah, I think that they really missed out on that by not being in this conference and selling us on their vision for the future of Wii U. And one thing that really has to happen after this E3 is Wii U needs a price cut. It really does. And I know Nintendo is a company that likes to make profit for every hardware unit sold. They don't like to sell anything at a loss, which I understand. And they've been really successful at that, even when it sold GameCube. I really respect that, but at the same time, a PS3 is like $100 or $50 less than the Wii U as a bundle. The GTA 5 edition of PS3, with 500 gigabytes of hardware storage. The Uncharted 3 edition, which is still being sold out. Uncharted 3 edition with 250 gigabytes of storage is $269.99. Compare that to Wii U. I know the Wii U is a bit more sophisticated than the PS3, but this PS3 has much more hard drive space and actually has a game with it, and you still cost more than the PS3, you have a problem. That's a big problem. Wii U needs a price cut badly. Badly. Get rid of the basic model, make the deluxe version like what the basic model costs. Needs a price cut badly because the deluxe model is $50 cheaper than the PlayStation 4. Again, that's a huge problem. And when Reggie Fils Aimé was kind of like, you know, talking with Jeff Keighley and being interviewed, he's a great speaker. Everything he says is right, actually. He talks the truth. It's all about the games. You know, you're going to like these Nintendo games. We will. Those Nintendo games look so awesome. They look like really fun games, and every month for the Wii U, starting from August, it's going to get something from their first party. But its future is kind of just being like that other console that you play Nintendo games on. And it really depends. How much love do you have for Nintendo games? How much love do you have for Nintendo games? I think that's the bottom line question for whether you're going to get a Nintendo Wii U or not. But here's the thing. Those Nintendo games are not Nintendo games that like push the boundary. It kind of feels like cookie cutter stuff. Super Smash Brothers, exciting stuff, but how does it push the boundary? From the previous Super Smash Brothers, they're adding Bilizer as a character. They're adding Wii Fit Girl as a new surprise character. Like, if that's their innovation, like, where is this going? I mean, Mega Man looks cool and all, but like, wow, really? I didn't expect a new Zelda because they just did Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, and I know that took like 5 years to make. Every Zelda game is such a humongous, lengthy, elaborate process. It makes sense why they didn't really announce Zelda. They're also doing a Zelda game on the 3DS anyway, so that makes total sense, but it's just, there's no boundary-pushing games that are coming out on the Wii U, except maybe for Pikmin 3 and X. I think those two games are the ones that are really pushing the boundary. Mario Kart 8 actually looks to be the most innovative of all the Nintendo first-party games. That's saying something when Mario Kart is the most innovative Nintendo game out of all the games that are showcased for the future of Wii U. Honestly, I'm excited. At the same time, I'm disappointed. One can argue that this is the best lineup out of the E3, the Nintendo's lineup. But one could also argue that this is the most disappointing lineup of the entire E3. So, and they're both true to me. It's not like I disagree with one position or the other. They're both true to me. And I think this could have been solved if Nintendo actually just kind of gives a clear vision of what it wants to do, what it's planning. I don't know. Wii U is kind of weird. The future of Wii U really is weird for me. As I've said in a previous video, it can really go either way. And it does kind of depend on third-party support, what's going to happen with that. But I do wonder, how much do people love Nintendo so much that they're only going to buy this console just for Nintendo games? I really have to question that, because I like Nintendo's games, but I'm not the type to, at this price, at the price that it is, I mean, even with the price cut, it's still a hard sell. I don't know, maybe I'm just a weird audience for it, but if I get a Nintendo Wii U, the games that really excite me, I don't care about really Mario Kart 8. Super Mario 3D World looks cool, but I'm not sold on it simply because I played Super Mario 3D Land, and I don't know, Catsuit looks cool, but this is It kind of looks very similar, except with really pretty graphics. Graphics are really pretty on that thing. Donkey Kong Country Tropic Freeze looks pretty cool. But if I get a Wii U, the games that really excite me are, it's weird, I don't know why, but Sonic Lost World really interests me. X really interests me. Pikmin 3 is pretty interesting. But it's like nothing out there that just like super grabs me, you know? It's just weird. I don't know why I don't have that feeling for any of the Nintendo games. Just like, buy me, that I'm feeling with so many other games that are on the other platforms, including PS3 and Xbox 360. So, I don't know if Nintendo is having a communication issue or a marketability issue, or is just that the games are just kind of cookie cutter. Nintendo is really, really, really playing safe this year. And I think it's kind of hurting them, especially considering the fact that they didn't have an actual gigantic, grandiose press conference. They did have their Nintendo Direct during E3, but it wasn't successful. The stream didn't work, and they tried to they didn't allow all the other press, you know, all the other gaming sites like Game Trailers or GameSpot or IGN to actually stream that and utilize the other gaming networks to let their message be known throughout the whole gaming audience. Didn't happen. They had servers go down, streaming was a mess, it was not successful. I think E3 2013 was a huge success, except for Nintendo. That's kind of shame. That's really shameful.